I want to suggest the reason that we're doing it is one that John gives us in his first letter. He says this. This is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. See, we're not here today to trumpet our love. Because this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us. We're here today because God has loved us. And it's that love that brought about this project. John goes on, dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. That's the reason. And I don't know if this is possible, and maybe Ray will do this for us, but I would love that to go down in some history book somewhere, that is why we are doing this. We are doing it because God loved us, and we cannot but respond to that. I'd love that to go on a plaque somewhere, so that it's buried in history, because who knows what will happen in the future. You know, maybe it is that these homes for the elderly just go on and on and on, long after we've gone. I would love people to remember why this has come about. It has come about because God so loved us. And we just want to respond.
Good neighbours, there's nothing like it, is there? So thank you for coming.
You do, Barry.
Please feel free to explore. We better count how many are here, so we make sure we don't leave anybody in the bush. But it does go quite a long way through, right through to the allotments. Where is everybody?
They're all disappeared.
I was joking about counting them.
Well, I think you might need to.
Yes, I know, it's brilliant.
Camera shake.
very, very dry. That's why it's so hard.
Yeah. And how far down is that?
It's about 2 metres.
Wow.
But we'll stop this hole here. There's no point going any deeper.
That's plenty, isn't it?
Coming to hear about the homes that you can hopefully one day move into. God has been the centre of this project right from the very beginning. So at the outset, we'd like to recognise that whereas we've been working hard pushing the project forward, it has been God at the centre. Even to the point when we've been meeting with our architect and our quantity surveyor, we've started every meeting with prayer. And that has caused some raised eyebrows at the offices of the architect and the quantity surveyor when these strange people from this church want to start a business meeting with a word of prayer. But that actually is just a demonstration of the fact how God is at the centre of everything. We do recognise at the start of the presentation we've got an awful lot of information to share with you.
Hallams have just arrived to start work on the development. Sixth of May 2003.
Spot on. Have your cup of tea now, sweetheart.
I will. I'll just get out of the way so I can get out. What's that?
You can pick 4.5 ton up with that.
Well, you've got the listener on, have you? All right. Yeah, I think that's around about 4 ton in weight.
Excellent again. Now we're actually here on the site to remind ourselves of some of the key points of what has happened in the past and also just to look ahead a little bit to the future. Of course, if you've been at Knighton over the last months, you will have heard much of this, and if you were with us last Saturday at our meeting, you will have heard this. But now we're actually here on the site and we can walk on the ground. It is an excellent opportunity just to pause again and remind ourselves of where God has brought us thus far. It was way back in the 1970s that our brother Stan Hollins had a vision for this kind of a place. Stan is in a far better place now, but it is so thrilling that his family are here. And even more so that his wife Doris is going to be living right behind me here. So in about a year's time, she'll be sitting outside in a rocking chair inviting us in for a cup of tea. So that really is thrilling. It's thrilling that God has kept us going over all these years after that vision so many years ago.
Well, it's the 300th anniversary of John Wesley's birth, I think, sometime this month, and I think this is the nearest I'm going to get to John Wesley, although I don't think he had these speakers around at the time. Let me just read to you a psalm which we often read, but it's a psalm of thanks. Psalm 100, shout for joy to the Lord all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. But what do we want? What is our vision for the site? Let me say this. It is a vision of a Christian community, of elderly people who live here, who are a light to the neighborhood around. We want this place to resound to the glory and praise of the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. We want this place to be a brilliant light.
Metres below the top of that
rack. Wow.
Top of the pipe.
Thank you. Thank you. together now and forever.
Well, they've got it easy now.
Don't say that.
Power tools and stuff like that.
I think that creamy kind of looked nicer than that then. So yeah, with it.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello, Margaret.
I brought my daughter and a similar. Where's Kath? Oh, she's gone. Down the front there with the little drop. This is my son, Stephen. This is Laura. That's all.
chosen by Enrique Iglesias this week.
Different colour. So if I press the button now, this will raise a call on the handset.
If you hear any bad language, it'll be the electrician.
On the that's the call there. If you press your phone symbol and listen to the message, the system actually talks to you this time. There's no.
And what about the guarantee period? What sort of defects period are we talking about?
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for coming on this glorious June morning. I'll say no more. It's my privilege on behalf of Knighton Evangelical Care Limited and the Knighton Evangelical Free Church to welcome you all on this very special occasion. Let me introduce the members of the team. Oliver Coughlin. And Catherine Parker. They're both directors and trustees of Knighton Evangelical Care Limited. David Wisdish is our director and company secretary. David, where are you? Ray Pierce, director and chairman. Where's he? In addition, our project team members, Cliff Pine. Where's Cliff? Graham Coleman. Man with the camera. Our accountant, Peter Blackwell, do you know, he's got another appointment. Wimbledon, he says, tennis. Danny Blair, our minute secretary. Danny, where are you? Also with additional help from Janet Lowe and Chris Dorr. I don't know if they're here. Thank you for your background work. Not forgetting our two retired directors, Alison Timmins and Jane Cogan. Yeah, good. Good to see you. Thank you. A big, big thank you for being such a brilliant team right throughout this project. And now, of course, to Jenny, our warden. Jenny, where are you? Jenny's at the back there with her husband, Keith. And it's lovely to have Jenny on board. Welcome. Also to our professional team, architects, Martin Wilson and Chris Haylock, at the back there. Any complaints? He's the guy. Builders, Hallams, represented here today by their managing director, John Hallam. John? Oh, and Keith as well. Good to have Hallams represented here this morning. Thank you. Peter Willows, our quantity surveyor, that's WD Partnership in Nottingham, does send apologies but wishes us success today. Peter Hall, Engineering Services Design Limited, don't want the Peters here. Barry Smith, civil engineer of Paul Redding and Partners. Tony Airy, director, and Martin Crossley from the Bank of Scotland. They risked lending us the money. I think they're absent, is that right? Oh no, we've got Bank of Scotland here, right? Well done, thank you. That's a big relief. Washbrook Allotment Society, just over the road. Are any here from Washbrook Allotments? No? Oh, well done. There's your neighbours, folks, so keep them. And to all the many workers who have added their vital income contribution to what is here today, from us all a very big thank you. Our first hymn, Love Divine, All Loves Exile. Now, you officially open Knighton Homes.
This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvellous in our eyes. Knighton Homes, developed by Knighton Evangelical Free Church, opened on the 26th of June, 2004. By me. Vision to provide retirement accommodation and called together the first committee on April the 3rd, 1984. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God.
Well, Doris, thank you very much. It's wonderful, isn't it? Somebody just came in now, looked around, I think, for the first time and said, isn't it fantastic? And it is. It really is. I just want to think, why has this come about? Why did Stan and the others have this vision? What motivated them to do it? You know, often I'm motivated by things like pride, to be honest. I want to do it because somebody's going to give me a pat on the back and say how wonderful I am, or because God is going to think how great I am, or I'm motivated by fear. I'm actually worried I'm going to let other people down. I'm worried that actually God is going to be disappointed with me. Is that what motivated Stan? Is that what motivated the others? I don't think so. You know, I think if Stan were here today, I never knew him, but I kind of feel as if I did, because so many people have talked to me about it. He would be here right now with a chisel, trying to chisel off his name. And we'd be saying, no, Stan, no, don't do that, it needs to stay. But he'd also be here with a bit of polish, and he'd be polishing up that verse. It comes from that reading that we had. It says, this is love. Not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. See, when God sent his son into the world, he wasn't motivated by pride or by fear. After all, who does God have to impress? Who does he have to fear? He's God. No, God is motivated by love. And so the Bible goes on, it doesn't just kind of leave it there. It then says to us, dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. Those who have been behind this project, from Stan Hollins right at the beginning to the present day team, have all been motivated by the love of God.
Praise the Lord! Praise the Lord!
Put over the rain. That was on the mule.